Today on the show, we're going to be talking to a PPE expert. Wonder what that is? Yeah, I did too. Personal protection equipment. For us as IAs, whether you're an auto damage appraiser, property adjuster, doesn't matter. We are touching a lot of things of other people's, and we have no idea if that person was sick. So here in the post-coronavirus era, we now are aware that we need to take care of ourselves a little bit more and protect ourselves as we're touching other people's things and exposing ourselves to other people's germs. So I'm going to be bringing Justin on, and he's going to be sharing with us how we can better protect ourselves and families as IAs. Hey IAs, and welcome to the Auto IA Show by IA Path. At IA Path, we help you break through the experience requirements. You know how most companies require that you have 3 to 5 years worth of experience? We know that most new IAs cannot meet those requirements. That's why we help you break through them with our 90-day mentorship program. If you're interested, head over to iapath.com. For all the best tips, tricks, and tools, head on over to Adjuster TV's YouTube channel and click the subscribe button. While you're there, make sure you hit the bell notification so you can get notified every time you have a new video. Let's bring on Justin and find out how we can protect ourselves. But first, do you need errors and omissions, general liability, drone insurance, or even cyber liability coverage? Then let me tell you about our sponsor, Claims Professionals Liability Insurance Company, or CPLIC. Founded 16 years ago by independent adjusters, for independent adjusters, they want to give you peace of mind while you work with the insured. To apply, head over to cplic.net today. All right, IAs, I am joined by Justin Wexler, and I'm not even going to try to remember what company he works for. I'm going to let him introduce himself that way, but he is going to kind of help us understand some things that we might be doing wrong during and after the coronavirus. We live in a new era of how am I going to keep myself safe from, you know, viruses that maybe more dangerous than what we're used to in the past. And as appraisers, as adjusters, we're touching people's cars, which they're loving up on their steering wheels. They're sneezing on them. They're coughing them. So if they've been sick, we're potentially exposed. So Justin's going to tell us some of the things we might be doing wrong as far as protecting ourselves as IAs. Justin, welcome. I'd love to give you a chance to introduce yourself now properly in your company and kind of tell people what you do and then kind of how we can better protect ourselves.
Thank you so much, Chris. Really appreciate it. And hello to everybody out watching. I am helping our family company, running our family company, Quality Healthcare Disposables. We've been a medical and dental supply dealer since 1954, founded by my grandfather, run by my father for 45 years. And for the longest time, we were just some business. You drove by on the road, meant nothing to anybody. You've called, try to sell someone gloves. They, you know, we got a guy, doesn't matter. So we never meant anything up until about January 30th when the first internet order came in for some masks. And then from then, it's been just kind of a zoo. So yeah, there's a whole new focus now on keeping ourselves safe. And so that's a little bit about us. We do have a website, qualitydiscountdisposables.com, and that has a lot of the current stuff and some other specialty stuff for medical. But yeah, we've been supplying dentists and vets and retirement living communities and all that stuff for many, many, many years.
Now, one thing that got my attention for those watching and listening is Justin can get bleach, sanitizer, even toilet paper. And when he reached out to me, we've known each other for a little bit. He used to work at Auditex, and you guys probably know Auditex, but now that he's doing this, he's like, do you know anybody who needs PPE? And I'm like, I'm gonna be the idiot here. I don't know what PPE is. What are you talking about? And so, Justin, what is PPE and why is it important in this day and age to IAs?
Yeah, absolutely. So it's personal protection equipment, and it sort of encompasses anything in terms of physical stuff like gloves, masks, eye protection, gowns, shoe covers, hair covers, all that, and also sanitizers and cleaning agents, and it's all that whole package of products.
Perfect. So if you guys are watching and you're like, wait, did they say hand sanitizer? And you need some of that stuff, you can head to their website. We'll give it to you again at the end. But Justin, you know, we talked real brief before we jumped on this call together to make sure we kind of knew what we were going to talk about. But, you know, some of the things you're explaining to me is like, we got to understand how this virus is responding or how we're responding to the virus as a human beings to better understand how to protect ourselves. So why don't you kind of explain to us what's going on?
Yeah, thanks. And I'll keep this quick. I know we all know all we want to about it, but this is a novel virus, zero immunity. That means it's the actual type of virus is RNA, came from an animal. So if you come in contact with it and if it gets ingested in your body, you are going to get it. Your strong immune system means it doesn't even know this is something it needs to fight. It's like a side door. It doesn't recognize an RNA because it's an animal virus. That's the problem. That's why bird flu, swine flu, all these other ones, they were things, but this one has some special stuff to it. So that's one of the big problems, is that there's zero immunity. And the other biggest problem is that you are contagious before you are symptomatic for a couple days. So that's a big problem. That's unique. Typically, that doesn't happen. So one of the problems is how it spreads is typically through physical droplets that come out of our mouth. And so the biggest thing about wearing a face mask is that's going to protect you from projecting what you have into the room. It does offer a layer of protection against things that are out in the air, but generally it's physical contact. And generally the way people get sick is by actually ingesting it themselves, it on their hand, they touch their face, they put it on something, they put it in their mouth. Typically we actually kind of force it into ourselves unless you have direct physical contact or direct immediate exposure. Gas pump handles are thought to be a major risk or contributor of spreading. I live in Detroit. And that was one of the first things. There was a whole bunch of phantom cases. Nobody knew where they were getting it from. They think it's gas. They were thinking it's gas pump handles. So that's something.
Me, I look at that little credit card machine. I got to push all the buttons on and on the gas pump or in the grocery store. And I'm like, here we go. God help me, keep me safe, and then spray my hands, right? Yep. But, yeah, totally. That makes complete sense. So us as IAs, because we're getting in cars and or walking into people's houses, inspecting them for damage that exists, these people don't necessarily know they've been sick if they are sick, right? Is that kind of what you're explaining to us? Is
yes. Like, yes, that's exactly. There's a short window, a couple days, 2 days, something different for everybody. There's also people that have a weird natural immunity that's not understood, where some people are actually sick, but they don't get the sickness associated with it, but they have the virus. I don't know if they can communicate, if they can actually transmit it or not. There's a lot of weird things. This is very different, and there's some things that they just don't understand yet. One of the best pieces, one of the only good pieces of news, is that it's an enveloped virus, and all that means is that it's as easy to kill as opening an envelope. It's very easy when it's not inside a host anyway. So all you need is, that's why they say washing your hands, soapy water. The water allows the soap agent to get through the outer membrane and it kills the virus very quickly. Alcohol, bleach, regular hand soap, hand sanitizer, anything. And it actually, you don't want it to be super strong. You want it to be a little bit more like a 70% solution, bleach down to 10%, so that that's, you know, safe to just work with and breathe. But anyway, you don't need very much. It's very easy to kill. The other really great, the best analogy I heard is to imagine the world is covered in wet paint. Everything's wet paint. So whatever you, when you touch something and then you touch something else, it is now wherever you touched. And that is the biggest thing. That's so grocery stores, anywhere, any common areas. That's why playgrounds are off limits, even if it's outside. Because once you touch something, it's on there and it moves around and then you eventually ingest it. So stop touching your face. That, you know, this stuff is all, but that's why you stop touching your face. One of the biggest advantages to a face mask is it stops you from touching your mouth and your nose. Really, the virus needs to get into your lungs for it to really take hold. And it attacks the lungs specifically. It's a very dry cough. A lot of people don't know that. It's a dry cough. It's not, you know, it's not a sinus thing. It's a lung attack primarily was where it starts. Anyway.
So knowing that this kills easy, which is good news, knowing that, you know, it could survive for multiple days on a car handle, you know, on a whatever, right? Anything we're touching, dry paint, right? Takes a while to dry. You know, wet paint takes a while to dry. So what can we, as you're thinking through, like, okay, an IA is walking in, touching the door handle. We know we're done for. Like, right there, we know if that person was sick, it's still there, probably. The steering wheel, the door handle of the house to get in, the bathroom door handle to check where the leak came in. What should we be doing when we show up to a house or to a car to try to keep ourselves safe?
Yeah, so the standard things that are being recommended, a face mask is ideal. Again, mostly to protect yourself. It does have off from you communicating it should you be unaware, but it does also protect with the outside. So a face mask is very important. Rubber gloves are – so here's the thing with sanitizer is great. Soapy water is great. The thing is, the more you put on your hands can dry out. You know, your skin gets dry. Once it cracks – you now lost a barrier of protection. And that's a problem because now you have a potential entry point. Your skin is actually a defense. So that's why rubber gloves are really ideal. It's not an only solution because, again, well, you can still get it on the glove and then cause problems, and you might even be a little less aware when you're wearing gloves. But really it's a combination of gloves, sanitizers, alcohol. You want to keep it off of your skin, or at least wash it off or kill it as soon as you do unwrap. So you have rubber gloves, face protection, and more than anything, avoid going inside. Stay outside 6 feet, you know, or more. That's the biggest thing, is if you can stay outside and just talk through, you know, from a few feet away, stay out of buildings. That's the biggest thing, the fresh air and not touching anything. You could just about get by with nothing. but those are some really good kind of general practices there. So with hand sanitizers, there's different types of sanitizers. There are liquid solutions that you spray. You can put that with a paper towel to make your own wipe. They come in gallons and concentrates and all different stuff. There's those type of sanitizers. There's aerosols, which are hard to find, your Lysol and that stuff, that aerosol can. Concentrates you dilute into a gallon quantity against spray bottles, things like that. There's the gel, the hand sanitizer gel, which is, you know, we know that in the bottles and that stuff. And there's obviously the soapy water. Rubbing alcohol is one of my favorite things. To have that in a spray bottle, you just shoot on your hands. It doesn't stain like bleach.
Would that be good for keyboards? So I'm sitting here thinking about the keyboard. We come back to the keyboard. And then, like, before we start, we should spray our hands, spray the keyboard, you know, is rubbing alcohol, would that work for that? I mean,
yeah, I would spray it. It'd actually be great for it. I would spray it on a paper towel, you know, spray a towel and then use that like a wipe. But yeah, it's fantastic. Again, it's not going to be, or a 10% bleach solution would really kill. Bleach is the ultimate annihilator. It kills everything. So really a 10% bleach solution, but then it's bleach, so you have clothes and stains, and so that's why I prefer alcohol. But yeah, 70% concentration, you don't want it. The 91% or 99%, you have to dilute down, add a little bit of water. When it's that strong, one, it evaporates too fast. Two, it has a hard time penetrating through the virus membrane. It needs a little bit of water. The water kind of tricks the membrane where it sees water. It says, okay, you can come in. And then it brings the alcohol, which actually kills it. And there's also a kill time. So, all right, let's talk about wipes for a second. There are normal wipes like bleach, Clorox wipes. Then there are germicidal wipes. A germicidal wipe has hydrogen peroxide as the main additive. Not sure what other chemicals it has. That's the big thing with a germicidal wipe. With any wipe, you want to be using rubber gloves every time. I'm sure if you read the fine print, the lawyers probably tell you, don't put it on your skin. The germicidal wipes, it's a little more clear. I haven't looked at a Clorox one yet, but I'm sure it's on there. So you want to wear a rubber glove, or if you want a cheap glove, a polyethylene, you know, the lunch lady food service gloves, the real loose fitting ones, they're like $1 for a decent sized box, dirt cheap. So if you're just going to wipe something down real quick, you don't want to use a nice glove. That's ideal. But yeah, so you always want to use a glove or some sort of protection when you have a wipe. But a germicidal wipe specifically, I think all wipes have a kill time. I know germicidal do. So it could be 1 minute, 2 minutes, 3 minutes, various. It's just the amount of time that it has to be on there applied to actually kill everything that it's supposed to, that it's going to. And then with most of those wipes, you're actually supposed to remove it with like a dry cloth. You're supposed to wipe it down and remove whatever's left behind. Probably a good idea with a bleach wipe as well. Those are real commonly used, so I don't know if people all do that, but it's a good idea.
So family of four, let's use that as an example. How much hand sanitizer, wipes, bleach, what should we have on hand? Because honestly, nobody has an idea of how long this could go on. Sure, they're going to be loosening restrictions now. Doesn't mean the threat's gone away. Just means, hey, we think the hospitals can handle it. Hey, we're going to try to get the economy running again. We don't want to go too far that way. So, but what should we be trying to have on hand as a family?
That's a great question, and it's a subject I wanted to bring up. So this is not going away. And years and years, notice how not one medical professional is talking about getting rid of it. It's all slowing the spread, which typically when one person gets infected, they infect at least two, if not three or more other people. You can have that in your own household before anybody else that you don't even know about. Years and years, this is going to go on. And it's because there's zero immunity. They're talking about until we reach 70% infection of the population, things not normalizing until then. So this isn't going away. So I'm not suggesting people go and stock up and buy 85 cases of everything. That's not responsible. But you do want to make sure you have enough for probably a month. And maybe try to order, you know, like if you're going to order a gallon, if you have a big family, you're going to put bottles all over, then, you know, have a backup gallon. And then as soon as you open that one, I would probably start working on ordering another one. You know, you want to, or maybe even more, you know, you have to manage that yourself, but you want to make sure you have an inventory. This is not going away. It's only going to get worse. And the more that we are responsible as people and stay away and stop ourselves from getting infected, as people are more responsible, and it may not be so bad. There's just still a lot of people that are not doing everything right, and that's where the problems are going to keep kind of building and going. This is here, unfortunately, to stay. It's the horse is way out of the barn.
Yeah, of course. So now that we know kind of some of the things we need to get, most of us, we started off, we can't find these things in the grocery store. And we kind of said that, hey, you guys have it. So if somebody's hearing this going, I'm almost out of gloves. I can't get gloves. I can't find sanitizer, Clorox. That's all great and fine and good. How do I protect myself, Justin? So tell them about your guys' website. Tell them, because, you know, we could get a little bit just for ourselves, but really it's our family and stuff I think that we need to think about as well. Not just the appraiser who's out in the field, but also when you come home. If you're not protecting at home, you might actually just takes one time to bring something back. So how can people connect with you guys, and how can they get supplies for you guys?
Yeah, great. So the best way is to probably reach out to me directly through LinkedIn. We also have a Facebook page. It's under my name, Justin Wexler. I don't usually check LinkedIn. Facebook, we have a company page, QHDINC. So at QHD Inc., Quality Healthcare Disposables is the company. We are working on building out the website now where we're going to add a lot of the household. We never marketed the household stuff because people could just go and get bleach. So we have a whole glove shop, latex and nitrile rubber gloves. There are potential latex allergies out there, so use nitrile if you have that situation. We're going to be – all the PPE stuff is there. Household stuff, we can get anything from bleach to rubbing alcohol, paper towel dispensers, roll towels, TP. We've been a paper distributor for I don't even know how many years, 30, 50 years, always local delivery. So one thing we do is we put mixed boxes together for people. Give me one of this, one of that. We can pack some odds and ends in there. Instead of packing material, we'll pack it with paper products to fill the box. And then you're a whole case of paper towels is oversized, so it gets a little pricey to ship. But that's a way where you can get some supplies, things like that. We have a supplier who has some really unique capabilities. They're set up with Procter & Gamble, 3M. They're set up with literally probably a couple thousand companies, direct OEM company, you know. So when I place a dropship order, you're getting it from 3M or from Procter & Gamble a lot of times. I can get toothbrushes.
They contact you directly if they need it?
Yeah, for right now, yes, that would be best.
What's your email, just in case they have trouble getting you on LinkedIn Facebook?
Yeah, that'd be great too. Yeah, QHDINC@yahoo.com. QHDINC@yahoo.com. Yeah, QHD Inc., Quality Healthcare Disposables. So yeah, there's the direct email. We are going to be adding the stuff to the site. So anytime they mention IAPath, we'll do something for them. Typically on a small order, we throw in something for free. If it's a bigger order, we'll give a price discount.
Awesome.
So, you know, appreciate we kind of manage that depending on case by case. It also depends on where, if it's drop shipping or coming from our warehouse. So but if they mention IAPath, we'll definitely do something for them. Cause you know, you guys are awesome. And I know you, been doing so much help for everybody and, yeah, we really like what you guys have been doing.
Well, I appreciate it, Justin. Thanks for taking time out of your day. Thank you for trying to help us keep us and our family safe. And, you know, just keep doing what you guys are doing. It's really fun that, you know, the relationship we had through the auto damage industry, even though you shifted industries, is now we're now able to network in a different way. And I think that's just so cool. You know, we talk a lot about networking. We talk a lot about the importance of how that's how you get work a lot of times. But man, it goes so much further than that, that now you're able to help our community and this industry in the time of need when we're really up against the wall. So I really appreciate it. Thank you guys for what you're doing.
Oh, thank you. And yeah, everybody stay safe. And yeah, hopefully we'll talk again soon.
Will do.